How did the Americans come up with a 30-cylinder engine for the Sherman tank? The M4 Sherman had many different versions, powered by all kinds of engines. Some ran on diesel and were shipped to the Soviet Union. Others used converted aircraft engines. But in 1942, engineers in Detroit came up with something truly unique. Chrysler decided to take 5 6-cylinder car engines and bolt them together into one massive unit, creating a 30-cylinder monster. This became the Sherman M4A4 with the Multibank engine. The result was astonishing. Displacement, nearly 20 liters. Weight, over 2 tons. Power output, around 425 horsepower. Fuel consumption, about 2 liters of gasoline per kilometer. The engine was so large that the tank's hull had to be stretched and redesigned. And because it was really 5 separate engines working in unison, maintenance was a nightmare. American crews often found it overly complicated and fuel-hungry. Yet this strange design had one surprising advantage. If one engine, or even 2, failed, the tank could still move. The driver could decide which of the 5 engines to run and which to shut down. In a way, the Sherman became more reliable in combat, able to limp on when other tanks would be stranded. The Americans themselves never really embraced it, but the British saw its potential. They adopted the M4A4 in large numbers and turned it into one of their most famous variants, the Sherman Firefly, armed with a powerful 17-pounder gun. This version gave Allied crews a fighting chance against the fearsome German Tigers and Panthers. So in the end, what started as a bizarre experiment in Detroit helped create one of the most effective Allied tanks of World War II,